Hi, I'm Robin Worley, welcome to LensCraft. Today, I've moved over to an old Windows computer, but it's a bit clunky. It's now 9 years old and struggling, but I'm here because I want to look at ACDSee Ultimate 2021, which recently launched. I'm going to explore two of the new features, which are the colour and tone wheels. To do this, I'll be using a RAW file which I shot a few days ago and which I've opened in ACDSee's Develop module. I've already made some changes to the image for exposure, contrast, colour balance and sharpness. If I click the Show Original button, you can see the changes. In case you're wondering, most of the improvement to the colour comes from adjusting the tones and contrast in the general panel. Notice that I haven't adjusted the saturation or vibrance to achieve this. Now let me demonstrate the tone wheel where I can shift the colours depending on how light or dark they are in the image. An example of this is the beach, which currently has a slight green tint to it. Let's shift this to more of an orange or a yellow colour. The new tone wheel helps you target colour adjustments based on image tone, which is how dark or light the area is. To do this, we have three wheels which target the highlights, midtones, and shadow tones in the image. The area I want to adjust sits mainly in the shadow tones of the image, so I'll use the shadow tone wheel. Around the outside of the wheel is a marker which I can use to move or set the hue that I want to introduce into that tone. I'll move this to be between red and orange. Over to the left of the wheel is a control to adjust the saturation. When the slider is at the bottom, there's no saturation in the adjustment, so it doesn't have any effect on the colour. But as I move the slider up, the saturation increases and the colour shift becomes more obvious. Notice also that as I increase the saturation, the marker on the colour wheel moves away from the centre. That's because the unsaturated colours are at the centre of the wheel, whilst the saturated colours are on the outside edge. You can also click and drag this marker with your mouse to set the colour. The other slider on the right of the tone wheel controls the brightness of the tones you're targeting. When it's in the centre position, there's no change, but as I move it up, it lightens the tones, and move it down and it darkens them. For this image, let's use a moderate saturation and darken the tones a little more. You can check the difference this is making to the image by turning off the panel with the switch at the top. Now let's add some more blue to the midtones as well as darken them slightly. Finally, I'll shift the highlights towards yellow. Again, we can turn the panel off and on to check the effect. Now let's move over to look at the new colour wheel. This allows us to target adjustments based on colour in the image rather than the tone. Let's say that we want to target the yellow in the sky. If I click on the area, ACDSee takes a sample and uses it to set the colour on the wheel. Notice the triangle that appears. This shows the range of colours our adjustment will affect. It's also possible to move the triangle manually by dragging the control with the mouse. When you do this, you'll see the image turn to a grayscale with only the selected areas now showing in colour. Once you've made your selection, you can apply the adjustments using the sliders. The smoothness slider, though, isn't a colour adjustment. It's used to refine the selection and can help with the precision adjustments, or, in the case of this image, with blending. If you watch the area to the edge of the selected range, you can see that the selection spreads slightly when I increase the smoothness. This can help blend your adjustments into surrounding areas. But if you were using this to replace the colours in an object like a car with well-defined edges, you might want to reduce the smoothness to increase the accuracy. Now let's look at a problem that you can see here, which is that the reds on the horizon have become too saturated by the adjustments. This is happening because they're a close match to the colours that we do want to target. We could try to remove the colour from the selected colour range, but this could negatively affect similar colours that we do want to enhance. Another way to overcome the problem is to remove the adjustment from the most saturated colours in the selection. You can do this by clicking the edge of the colour wheel and dragging it towards the middle, which is the less saturated colours. You can also do the same in the centre of the selection to remove the adjustment from less saturated colours if you need to. Now let's add a second adjustment to the wheel to target the blue in the sky. We can do this by clicking the plus icon. We can then make a selection and apply the adjustments as before. If we want to see the effect of just one of the colour ranges, you can then turn off the others by clicking the tick mark. And you can switch to the other colour ranges by clicking them in the list. I'll reset the colour and tone wheels now because I want to show you the edit module. If you want to equate these modules to Adobe products, I like to think them as develop being like Lightroom and edit being like Photoshop. I should also point out that you only get the edit module in the ultimate version of ACDSee. If you want the develop module, you can use either the professional or the ultimate versions. The two new tools that we've been looking at are now filters in the edit module which you can apply to pixel layers. Ideally, I would have liked to have seen these added as adjustment layers rather than filters. But as they are filters, I need to create a copy of my image first because I want to have the benefits of using them with layer masks. I can then add the color wheel filter to the new layer. I can then add a mask to the layer and then paint on the mask with black to hide the effect. Whilst I've only looked at a couple of the new tools in ACDSee, these are significant advancements in the latest version. If you're a Windows user and looking for an alternative to both Lightroom and Photoshop, ACDSee Ultimate is worth investigating. I hope you found today's video useful. I'm Robin Worley, you've been watching LensCraft, I'll see you soon for another video.